and Kora here at Atmosphere Gathering Music and Arts Festival. We're here this evening with Harpoonist and the Axe Murder. We have Sean and Matt. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
Yeah, good evening.
Welcome.
Shout out first to the Intent Creative Network for bringing over this incredible, gigantic tent from Glastonbury Festival. You guys just played in your first circus tent, as you mentioned during your set. How did that feel?
It felt great. When you have the weight of the history of Glastonbury behind you, that you can't let people down. You can see the mud that's embedded in the rooftop of that tent.
That is true.
And
yes.
You can smell the performances of years past. And so it's up to you to actually bring it, to carry forward the energy that's needed for this weekend.
Was it a rich history? You embedded in the tent's rich history?
It was potentially
kind of a little bit of an oasis.
Okay.
Was there a bit of a champagne supernova?
Champagne supernova was sort of hovering down upon us.
Did somebody get punched off the stage at the Phoenix in Toronto?
Yeah. There's a lot of history going on there.
We totally deserved it.
So, you guys have been playing tons of shows, going to lots of different music festivals on and off the island. I'm curious to know, what does festival culture to you? Do you want us to pause for a sec?
Yeah.
Okay, this is take two for Betty and Kora, here with the Harpoonist and the Axe Murder. We had to move locations based on the fact that Charlie Tuna's bass was a little too loud. So we got in really close and personal in the getaway van. How are you guys feeling? How do you like the getaway van?
I love it. It smells like flora and fauna. And it feels like a cashmere purse.
Perfect. So, Kora, you were in the middle of asking a question.
I was. So I'm curious to know, as you guys have been bouncing around so much, different festivals, on and off the island, what do festivals mean to you? What does festival culture mean to you? Harpoonist and the Axe Murder.
It's at this point of the year, it's actually come to resemble, should I still hold this as my mic, human potentiality. And I don't mean that like a vampire that needs to seek blood, which is kind of what I feel from a week-to-week basis, but you see what people are potential of as giving, loving people. And I don't think that I'm under an illusion of what a mistopia environment might be, but it taints your vision of what we're capable of, because we go back into our regular lives and we're like, ooh, the real world is kind of crappy. We're potential of so much more. So, if anything, yes, I feel like a vampire. I lost from these experiences. Sorry, why would I even change myself?
Can I just be the word Nazi and say that potentiality isn't a word?
In factuality, you're wrong.
Oh, ooh,
Mistopia?
Did I say miss? I meant this.
I liked it.
No one's looking at the experience. Yeah. Or the
except
the
Matt Rogers.
Except me.
Except, yeah. Yes, okay.
I've got one.
Okay, fine.
He's my Mrs. Doubtfire. Okay. Ooh, R.I.P.
Oh,
R.I.P. Let's have a moment.
Yeah.
Problems. R.I.P. Okay. So, our last question. If you guys had a fight, Harpoonist.
We've had a few.
Versus the Axe Murderer, who would win?
Ready?
It wouldn't end.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh, rock, paper, scissors.
No, I already
right
won
now.
Tonight.
Nope, do it on camera.
Okay,
ready?
Okay. On four.
Okay.
One, two, three.
One,
two,
one.
Three, four.
Ooh. Snap.
That's a first. That doesn't actually
first
count.
First two. What?
Okay, you're right here, ladies and gentlemen. Rock, paper, scissors. Settles it all.
That's it.
So, that's it.